title. And that means there's just the men's doubles to come. Hirokatsu, Hashimoto, and Noriyasu, Hirata of Japan in the four seeds against the unseeded combination of Pratama and Saputra. To say the future of women's badminton is very secure with talent like these two players on court. 19 and 20 years of age, everybody talks about the dominance of the Chinese in women's badminton. I think these are two players who can really challenge that dominance. Most talent and exciting times in world badminton. Exciting times not only because of the players, but exciting times because of the OSIM BWF World Superseries, the 12 tournaments each year, where all the top players are committed to attend. Five premier events now as well. So to the men's doubles, the last of this afternoon's finals, and Hirokatsu Hashimoto and Noriyasu Hirata, the number four seeds from Japan. Surprise, this Indonesian pair have been throughout the tournament. Unseeded, currently enjoying the highest world ranking ever. Only formed their partnership last year, and they're real youngsters. Well, at quarter-final stage, we had three Indonesian pairs and three Japanese pairs in the last eight, so I guess it's only fitting that we've got Indonesians against Japanese in the final. So here, Rian Agung Saputra, the 20-year-old. And Pratama, just 19 years of age. Both play at the JRIA club, and as you can see, my goodness, what a battle. Three of their four matches have gone the full distance, but they've beaten three seeded pairs along the way. The number two seeds disposed of in the second round, their teammates, and then the number six seeds in the quarterfinal, another Japanese pairing, and then more teammates, the number three seeds in the semi-final, disposing of Alvin Julianto Chandra and Hendra Afrida Gunawan. Having lost the opening game, came back in 46 minutes to secure it. 21-14 in the decider. So for Hirokatsu Hashimoto, the a 25-year-old, his partner a couple of years older, Noriyasu Hirata. First appearance here in India, world ranking of 10, seeded 4. But they're in great form because they reached the final of the Asian Badminton Championships last week in Chengdu. In the final, they beat the Olympic champions last week. Last out in the final, to Kai Yun and Fu Hai Fun. And they'll be wanting to do one better this week here in India. And look at their semi-final victory over the number one seeds, Koo Kian Kiat and Tambu Hyung of Malaysia. All of their matches in two straight games. 2-16, 2-19 yesterday against the Malaysian combination, and that really was very, very impressive. So Mark Spate from Germany, on the bar, and Zimbis Judge. Our court officials all give up their time to come and officiate at these events, and it's wonderful to see it all, Super Series events, officials from all over the globe. It's part of the BWF initiative that there should be an international flavour of umpires at these top tournaments. Officials in partiality, and also a great experience for the umpires, and it's not just the players we want to develop, all aspects of the game. Saputra in this year. And the remarkable thing about the Indonesians is they've never previously been beyond the second round of the Super Series tournament in India, and India in the final. Meeting between these two pairs, and that's quite understandable. Given that the Indonesians are such a new pairing. Oh, my goodness. Fantastic smash from Hashimoto. Perfect placement. Sort of power placement. Just one of the nice notes. It's in a women's doubles final, not able to produce.
Two,
yesterday. I've seen the praises of Hirata. I thought he was the man of the match as far as the semi-final against Kuhn Town were concerned. Here he is, 27-year-old. Japanese combination and their opponents. This is their first ever Super Series tournament final. We saw long, drawn-out rallies. Ooh, complete miss it.
Service over, 5-9. Service over, 10-5.
Oh, a fault has been called. Well, Mark Spates, the umpire, called a fault. I'm not quite sure what the fault was for. Was it for hitting the net, or was it for a double hit? Oh, I think he missed it the first time. Decision is final.
Service over.
Delays the nickname interval momentarily. 5-point advantage for the number 4 seeds. Right, here we are, the nickname interval. We've only had 4 minutes of play. Coach Park with Dubon. A lot of differences made in the Japanese badminton. Move to coach the Japanese team. And have a spell in Malaysia. And prior to being in Malaysia, he'd been in England. And everywhere he's been, he's made a huge impact on the standard of play. This Japanese pair, I have to say, is now a real threat in world teams. Saputra just trying to guide the shuttle back. need to somehow settle themselves down. And the angle. There's the power play. There's the angle chop, but just too steep on that occasion. Talented player, isn't he? And Pratama.
12-15.
Oh, he's won two medals at World Junior Championships. Looking for different angles, looking for opportunities.
Over 16-19.
than a year ago in June last year, and 195. Indication of their improvement. In just 13 minutes of play. That's a good play serve. And a push from Hirata. Once again, just enough pace. And a confirmation on the opening game. 21-17 for Hashimoto and Hirata. Coaches, plenty of notes written in those little notebooks. Things they've spotted throughout that opening game. Where they should be playing it, what they should be trying to do. Well, from the body language, it seemed to me as if Park Jubon was saying, look, you've got to occasionally, don't get drawn into all flat and fast, just occasionally stop the shuttle. The pace out of it. Ah, yeah, there we go. A little pushes down into the midcourt area. Work the lift. And he's a wise man, he's Park Jubon.
20 seconds.
Number four seeds from Japan. Well, plenty of instruction from both coaches, individual pairs. Just really, really, they can implement the tactics that they've been told to use. Into the rally first and foremost. Service front forward, spike above the waist. That's the problem with the flat pushes from that far side of the court. The drift is making the shuttle fly very fast, coming towards the Japanese player. And the losers will have to be careful to make sure they get enough angle on their shots. Signs to me as Park Jubon makes more loops in his precious notebook there. And two stands down and rises. Just beginning to let their heads go down slightly. 6 points adrift, of course. Here just to lift the spirits. So it's back into the second game. Nice performance smash there from Hashimoto. Pushing hard on the return of serve, it go long off the back line. That's very sharp from Hirata. 19 minutes of play. That's extraordinary, isn't it? Oh, if I remember correctly, the opening game of the women's doubles was 38 minutes. That was just the opening game. Here we are, halfway through the second game of the men's doubles, only 19 minutes of play. As far as the Indonesians are concerned, they've got to get themselves back into the second game. These couple of rallies are crucial, and that, sadly for the youngsters from Indonesia, is not a good sign. Seeds in the second round, and then their teammates, the number three seeds, Chandra and Gunawan, yesterday semi-final. They were so delighted with those two huge wins. And it'll be very difficult to lift themselves once again emotionally. Awareness of where to smash, having failed to get through the final smash from Hashimoto. Look, he sees that smashing across the body of Pratama is going to get the advantage. Yeah, that's magic. their way now. The Indonesian pair, a 12-point advantage for the number four seeds, Hashimoto and Hirata. Attack, in control of the rallies. And this has been a very impressive performance. And I thought yesterday, the way they disposed of Kuantan, number one seeds from Malaysia. I'm not surprised they were in the final last week as well. Having beaten the Olympic champions en route. This Japanese player, as I say, really have improved so much. Themselves at the net, knowing that partner can move around and cover the open spaces. And just 3 points away from the third PBA title. Both previous titles. Dutch Grand Prix and Osaka International. That's a big step up. The umpire, and I have to say I'm very surprised at that, incredibly surprised seeing that again. It was clearly in. Goodness me. And the umpire is now to overrule the new judge, and no doubt he was influenced by the gesturing of the Japanese players. All academic now, because there's 13 match points to Hashimoto and Hirata. And this time, third time of asking, and for Hirokatsu, Hashimoto and Noriyasu Hirata of Japan, the number four seeds, their first ever Super Series title, and they've won it in style. They disposed of the number one seeds yesterday, and today in the final they've totally outclassed their young Indonesian opponents. This the final rally, big open space, and the delights for Hashimoto and Hirata. 21-17, 21-9 in just 26 minutes of play. Really were superb throughout, weren't they? The Japanese pair really took control. But I have to say, for the Indonesians, well, they'll be bitterly disappointed with today's performance in the final, but they should be very proud of their performance this week to take out three seeded pairs, including the number two and three seeds, their teammates from Indonesia. That is something very special indeed. Never beyond the second round of a Super Series event, the Indonesians. That means that all five finals have been completed. Starting with mixed doubles and Indonesia's territory. That's it. And then Lee Chong Wei from Malaysia needed a marathon match to overcome the European champion Peter Gaeder. And then there was a marathon women's doubles that lasted an hour and 10 minutes. But the number one seeds Maeda Suetsuna won that one. And then what a delight to see Paul Tip. Of Thailand win that battle of the youngsters. And as we've just seen, men's doubles, the number four seeds Hashimoto and Hirata comfortably in the men's doubles final. So to the prize presentation for the men's doubles. Well, no doubt the biggest achievement of their young careers so far.
To give away the silver medal and the bouquet
Angga,
to the runners
Pratama
of this men's
doubles
event.
Silver medals, but no doubt it's only a matter of time before they go one better than this. An exciting dynamic pair. And there's no doubt in my mind they will improve further.
Thank you, Dr. Gupta. And I now request Mr. Jaiswal to escort His Excellency, the Ambassador of Indonesia, and Vinod Dhawan to please give away the check from Yonex India to the runners-up of this men's doubles event. Prize money of $7,600 for the runner-up in the men's doubles event from Indonesia. Thank you, gentlemen. Can I request the champions in the men's doubles of the Super Series, Hashimoto and Hirata, and Dr. Akhilesh Dasgupta, please,
to the champions, Hirokatsu, Hashimoto, and Noriyasu, Hirata. Their first ever Super Series title. They've been threatening for some time. They've had big wins over the big, more established pairs in world badminton. And finally, for them, the big tournament win. Their second final in 2 weeks.
Now, can I request His Excellency the Ambassador from Indonesia and President DBA, Mr. Vinod Dhawan, to come forward and give away the check from Yonex of $15,800 to the winners from Japan, the champions of this Super Series men's doubles event.
So as the men's doubles pair celebrate their victory. Death.
From Japan, the winners, Hashimoto and Hirata. Thank you, gentlemen.
First ever Super Series event staged in India.
Now can I call upon...
Yonex Sunrise India Open.
From...
And we really have seen some wonderful badminton this week. We've also seen the emergence of some rising stars. Three titles this week going to players and pairs who had never previously won a Super Series title. The five titles going to four different nations. There, the champions list. Two titles to Japan, of course, in the women's doubles and the men's doubles. The next doubles going to Indonesia. And the women's singles to Thailand in the form of Pontip Borana Prasatsuk It really has been a wonderful day of badminton. And of course, that concludes the fourth Super Series event of the year. 12 tournaments throughout the year, and of course, the Super Series progresses on to the Singapore Open in June. That's the 14th to the 19th of June. Followed the next week by the Indonesian Open. That's a premier Super Series event. So, after a great week here in Delhi, I hope you've enjoyed it. I certainly have. And until the next time, from all of us here,